the location that fits on the stage and is not in North America.
An igloo.
Sounds delightful. Ladies and gentlemen, this game is BlindLine. It begins in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Take off your mucklucks. This is my igloo. I can wear my mucklucks in the igloo if I want. What am I gonna ruin the carpet?
That polar bear rug did not come easy.
It's filthy. It's still got blood on the other side of it.
That's how you know it's authentic, Carol.
Exactly. But I'm saying a little dirt's not gonna bother. Look at here we go. Hey, is it ruined? Is it ruined? Oh fuck.
You're lying. You know what? You're the worst roommate ever. It's just, I have to say, you know, when Cheryl said, I got a guy, he can move in right away, I looked at her in the eyes and I just said, show me the money! Because igloos are not cheap! So that's why I needed you.
Well, I'm here, and I have the money.
And I appreciate that. Well, but you are a slob. You are just an absolute slob, Harold.
I'm not a slob. I've lived in very clean houses for short amounts of time before I had to leave. I mean, I remember my last roommate was so impressed. She came home one day. She looked around in the front room and said to me, "You had me at hello." Which, oddly enough, really supports what I just said. Now, I accidentally stepped in some Walrus shit, and I walked on there.
Exactly, that's what I'm going to say. It's not about the hello, Harold. When you're at the door saying hello, that's fine. You got your bloody mucklucks on, and I don't really mind as long as they're outside. But when you bring in whale flubber and just leave it about? Yo, inside my head I'm just screaming.
Don't waste it.
Bend over and I'll show you. That's what I think when I see your whale flubber, man.
I'm gonna leave that right there. I think you're just kind of throwing this out of you're blowing it up. It doesn't need to be. I mean, this igloo.
I would never blow up an igloo.
You're being way too literal with me right now. I know you're pissed, but here's the deal.
I use the bathroom, okay?
I didn't say you need to piss.
Nice.
I said that you were pissed, and I think it's because there's some rip. I think there's something else.
Yeah, you're a dirty slob, man. That's what it is.
Beyond that, man. Listen, I didn't want to mention this because I didn't want to seem like a bad roommate, but I read your ice diary. And I saw.
Damn it.
I saw that entry for November 8th. We talk about me and it says, "Today Chad really burned my ice block." In fact, if I see him
that's my nickname for you, it's Chad. Harold, when I write about you, my nickname is Chad. However you found that out, you're a genius.
Anywho, I read, and I quote, that if Chad Harold comes home tonight, it's more that goddamn whale blubber, I'm gonna rip off his shirt and let him know that if you were an ice cream flavor, you would be pralines and dick.
And you know how highly revered we hold the ice cream.
Harold? It hurt. It hurt a lot. And maybe I was passive aggressively smear whale blubber and why was shit on your carpet?
You know what? You spoke your hunting spear right through my bed, Harold.
Don't you hear what I'm saying to you? I never tried to hurt you, man. I made you that pillow with the embroidery that said, I'm melting! You were melting this cold heart, buddy. You were melting this cold heart.
That, you know what? It was a terrible joke right after you almost burned down our igloo.
I was trying to make up for it.
It was melting! Oh, look at this bloody pillow I'm gonna give you that says I'm melting! Oh, it's great. You know what?
What?
You know what I wrote in my journal that day? I can remember right off the top of my head. I just picked out my ice pick and I was pounding away, writing in the journal,